AI just decoded the Herculaneum scrolls, and academics are furious. Picture this, everyone. A group of Silicon Valley tech bros just triggered the biggest academic meltdown in classical studies since someone suggested Troy might actually be real.
I talked to conservators who essentially said I would never be given the permission to do anything with that material because it was too fragile.
In 2023, a computer science student named Luke Farritor became the first person in nearly 2,000 years to read words from the infamous Herculaneum scrolls, and the scholarly world absolutely lost its mind. So be sure to keep watching until the end of the video, because I'm going to take you through this breakdown that sparked fatal threats against researchers and ignited a bitter war between traditional academics and tech entrepreneurs that's still raging today. So don't click away. You won't want to miss these explosive controversies that are literally rewriting how we discover ancient history. Got your attention? All right, strap in. The drama started with something called the Vesuvius Challenge, where tech entrepreneur Nat Friedman decided to throw $700,000 at a problem that had stumped scholars for centuries. But here's where things get spicy. Instead of working through established academic channels, he basically said, forget the professors, and crowdsourced the entire thing to anyone with a computer and some machine learning skills. That is quite some audacity. Traditional classicists who had spent decades studying these scrolls suddenly found themselves competing against teenagers with Python scripts. The academic establishment went ballistic. Professors who had dedicated their entire career to painstakingly studying fragments of these carbonized scrolls watched in horror as outsiders started claiming victories using X-ray topography and AI algorithms. The criticism was savage. Senior scholars accused the tech world of treating ancient history like a video game, complete with leadership boards and prize money. They argued that understanding ancient texts required decades of linguistic training, cultural knowledge, and historical context that no algorithm could possibly replicate. But the tech team wasn't backing down. They fired back, claiming that traditional academia had been gatekeeping these scrolls for decades without making any real progress. While professors debated methodology in conference rooms, the scrolls remained unread and the knowledge trapped forever. The Silicon Valley approach was brutally direct. Throw computer power at the problem until it breaks. The controversy deepened when Luke Farritor's winning algorithm started revealing actual readable text. Using machine learning to detect tiny variations in the carbonized papyrus, his system could identify where ancient ink had been absorbed into the material, even though both the ink and papyrus appeared identical to human eyes. The technology was undeniably impressive, but it also raised uncomfortable questions about the future of classical scholarship. What really ignited the academic fury was how the discovery was announced. Instead of following traditional scholarly protocols, submitting to peer review, and presenting at conferences, the results were splashed across tech blogs and social media. Suddenly, everyone was an expert on ancient philosophy based on a few decoded lines about pleasure and food. The classical studies community felt completely bypassed, watching centuries of scholarly tradition get steamrolled by venture capital and viral marketing. The most cutting criticism came from professors who pointed out that reading text isn't the same as understanding it. Sure, AI could detect letter patterns, but could it grasp the nuanced philosophical arguments of Epicurean thought? Could it understand the cultural context of Roman villa life? The tech team's response was typically Silicon Valley. We'll figure out the interpretational part later. First, let's get the text readable. This wasn't just about ancient scrolls anymore. It had become a proxy war for the soul of academic research itself. With traditional scholars fighting to preserve rigorous methodology against tech disruptors who wanted to move fast and break things, even if those things were 2,000-year-old manuscripts. When the first decoded passages were finally revealed, they didn't just surprise scholars, they completely blindsided them. The text wasn't some mundane shopping list or administrative record that everyone expected from a Roman villa. Instead, Luke Farritor's AI had uncovered philosophical writings by Philodemius discussing pleasure, food, and the nature of happiness in ways that directly challenged how modern academics understood ancient Epicurean thought. But here's where the real controversy exploded. Traditional scholars immediately began questioning whether the AI translations were even accurate. The decoded Greek text suggested that ancient philosophers had far more nuanced views on hedonism than previously believed. But senior classicists weren't buying it. They argued that machine learning algorithms, no matter how sophisticated, couldn't possibly grasp the subtle philosophical distinctions that required decades of training to understand properly. The academic establishment struck back hard, claiming that AI was essentially hallucinating text patterns and that the translations were fundamentally flawed. Professor Richard Janko from the University of Michigan publicly stated that while the technology was impressive, the interpretations being promoted by tech enthusiasts showed a dangerous misunderstanding of ancient philosophical concepts. The implication was clear: stick to your computers and leave the thinking to the real scholars. Meanwhile, religious institutions began expressing serious concerns about what other scrolls might contain. The Herculaneum Library potentially held early Christian texts, lost gospels, and philosophical works that could challenge established theological doctrines. The Catholic Church, which had remained diplomatically silent during the initial breakthrough, started making pointed statements about the importance of proper scholarly oversight when dealing with potentially sensitive ancient religious materials. But the tech team wasn't intimidated by academic gatekeeping. They fired back by pointing out that traditional scholars had been sitting on these scrolls for over 250 years without making any meaningful progress. If the interpretations were wrong, at least now there was actual text to interpret instead of educated guesses based on tiny fragments. They accused the academic establishment of being more interested in protecting their professional territory than advancing human knowledge. The controversy intensified when questions emerged about who actually owned the rights to these newly revealed texts. Italy claimed sovereignty over all archaeological materials found in Herculaneum. But the scrolls had been distributed to various institutions and private collectors over the centuries. Suddenly, lawyers were getting involved, arguing over intellectual property rights to 2,000-year-old philosophy lessons. Now guys, before moving on, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and give a thumbs up and all that other YouTube goodness. Make sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on our weekly videos. It really, really helps the channel. Appreciate it. The dispute reached fever pitch when competing academic teams began producing different translations of the same passages. One group's profound philosophical meditation on the nature of pleasure became another team's mundane discussion about dinner preferences. Without clear scholarly consensus, the public was left wondering who to believe: the traditional academics with their years of training, or the tech innovators with their revolutionary tools. The situation became even more contentious when rumors spread that private collectors and tech companies were secretly negotiating deals to decode scrolls outside of academic oversight entirely. The possibility that crucial historical texts might be translated and interpreted by corporate entities rather than scholarly institutions sent shockwaves through the archaeological community. Some professors warned that commercializing ancient text recovery could lead to sensationalized misinterpretations designed more for viral content than historical accuracy. The real earthquake hit when institutions realized this technology wasn't going to stop with Herculaneum scrolls. Suddenly, every major archaeological site with damaged texts became a potential battleground between traditional scholars and tech disruptors. Vatican Library, which houses thousands of deteriorating manuscripts, found itself under pressure from tech entrepreneurs offering to help decode their most sensitive religious documents. The church's response was swift and brutal. Absolutely not. But the controversy exploded beyond just Catholic institutions. Jewish scholars raised alarms about AI potentially misinterpreting ancient Hebrew texts, while Islamic authorities expressed concerns about algorithms handling sacred Arabic manuscripts. The underlying question was terrifying for religious establishments: what if AI revealed interpretations that contradicted centuries of established doctrine? What if machine learning uncovered ancient texts that challenged the very foundations of modern faith? The academic world fractured into warring camps. Progressive scholars embraced the technology, arguing that democratizing access to ancient texts could revolutionize our understanding of human history. But traditionalists dug in their heels, warning that turning historical research into a Silicon Valley playground would destroy the careful, methodical approach that real scholarship required. Tenure battles erupted as universities struggled to decide whether to hire computer scientists or classical scholars for their archaeological departments. The geopolitical implications became explosive when countries realized their national treasures could be decoded by foreign tech companies. Egypt banned several American AI research teams from accessing damaged papyri, while Greece threatened legal action against unauthorized scanning of ancient texts. Italy went even further, passing emergency legislation requiring government approval for any AI analysis of archaeological materials found on Italian soil. Private collectors found themselves at the center of a feeding frenzy. Suddenly, every damaged scroll or manuscript fragment became potentially worth millions if it could be successfully decoded. Black market dealers began trafficking in deteriorated ancient texts, knowing that AI could now extract value from materials previously considered worthless. Law enforcement agencies struggled to keep up with a completely new category of cultural artifact smuggling. The ethical questions became even more disturbing when researchers realized the technology could be weaponized for historical revisionism. Authoritarian governments began funding AI projects specifically designed to discover ancient texts that supported their political narratives. The possibility of manufacturing historical evidence became terrifyingly real when algorithms could be trained to hallucinate convincing ancient writing patterns. Meanwhile, the original Silicon Valley team pushed forward with plans to commercialize their breakthrough. They announced a subscription service that would give paying customers early access to newly decoded texts, essentially creating a premium tier for ancient knowledge. The academic community exploded in outrage, arguing that human heritage shouldn't be paywalled by tech companies seeking to profit from cultural artifacts. The most chilling development came when intelligence agencies began expressing interest in the technology. If AI could read carbonized scrolls, what about modern documents damaged in fires, floods, or deliberate destruction? Suddenly, the same tools being celebrated for unlocking ancient philosophy were being eyed as potential weapons for espionage and surveillance. The battle lines are now clearly drawn. On one side, traditional academics, religious institutions, and governments trying to maintain control over cultural heritage. On the other, tech entrepreneurs, progressive scholars, and democratization advocates pushing for open access to human knowledge. The Herculaneum scrolls were just the beginning of a war that will determine who controls our understanding of the past and who profits from ancient wisdom. But what do you all think? Should ancient texts be democratically accessible to anyone with the technical skills to decode them? Or should interpretation remain exclusively in the hands of trained classical scholars? Let us know in the comments down below. And be sure to check out our next video on the end screens that should be coming up right now. The war over ancient knowledge is only just getting started.